Hi, I'm Linda Peterson. I'm going to show you today how to incorporate friendly plastic in with your mixed media projects. I know you mixed media artists out there are going to love this idea. We're going to make artifacts on today's episode of Friendly Plastic TV. Grab your friendly plastic pellets. You'll need, about an ounce. I have a little cap full here. Or if you have some leftover friendly plastic and you're going to paint your artifacts a different color, you can use any kind of scrap, any black, especially the backside of the foiled sticks work really well. Also, snappers work for this particular project. You're also going to need a mold, and I prefer the molds that are flexible. This one here is from Amoco, or you can use any kind of silicone mold. You'll need a little bit of gesso. I'm using some gesso that is, it's tri-art gesso sludge. It's kind of a gray gesso, and I love this gesso. It seems to really grab the friendly plastic and really keep the paint on there really well. So, We're going to actually first heat up our pellets. So I would just spill these onto the nonstick work surface that I'm working on here and heat them with either my heat gun or using the water method. And you will know that they are completely ready to work with when they are clear and when they stretch. It's like this. And you really don't need a whole lot. A little bit goes a long, long way. You'll also want to grab, some petroleum jelly. And I put some of that on my hands. I also rub a little bit of that into the mold. It just helps it release the design when you put it in there. And roll it into a ball. And then just press it down into the mold. And because your fingers are slick, this makes for a nice smooth surface on the back of the plastic. So you're just going to work the plastic into all of the areas of the particular mold that you're working on, and you're going to let this cool. Now you can dunk this into some cold water to kind of speed up that process, or you can let it cool on its own. You'll know when they're completely cool when they go back to their original color, like this one here, and then you just bend the mold and pop it out. It's like this. And I already have one finished right here. This one's already nice and cooled. So now what we're going to do is we're going to give this a coat of the gesso. And the reason we're using the gesso is because the friendly plastic is really slick, and so paint doesn't stick to it very well. In fact, it kind of beads up if you would apply paint directly to this. So by putting on a primer of gesso, we kind of eliminate that problem. And first I'm going to spritz this with a little bit of window cleaner. This is going to take off all the extra little oil that we put on there with the petroleum jelly. Okay. And now we're ready for a coat or two of the sludge gesso. I like using this gray sludge gesso because the color of the gesso here, it doesn't affect the color of the paint that you're going to be putting over the top of it. Just like that. And I think we're really only going to need one coat, but I'm going to have to let that dry on its own. Now remember, you cannot put heat to this because if you heat it, then you'll lose some of the impression or some of the design. So you kind of got to have to be patient a little bit and let that dry on its own. But let me go back while this is drying real quick, because I want to talk to you a little bit about the things you can do once you pull them out of the mold. Now, this isn't totally set. This is still a little bit clear. And while it is a little bit clear, then you can, it's still malleable. So if your final piece was going to go maybe on a bottle that's a little round, you could actually mold this and it will take the shape of the bottle. You can also take this out before it sets and you can kind of stretch and rework the facial shape a little bit or work the shape of any mold that you're using. So that's really cool about this. Now that it is completely dry, I'm going to come in with some brown paint and I'm just going to antique it. This is going to give it that old, aged, worn out look. Well, I hope your mind is running wild with ideas of things that you can recreate in Friendly Plastic, because we only touched the surface. We just antiqued, but you can make Friendly Plastic look like rusted metal, like copper. There's just so many things you can do with it, and I invite you to try. If you need more ideas on what to do with Friendly Plastic, you can go to our website at friendlyplastic.blogspot.com. There's free project tutorials, there's other videos, there's lots of eye candy to inspire you to create. And that's going to do it for this episode of Friendly Plastic TV. Thanks for joining me today. I'll see you again real soon.